Can't sing, they can't play.
Unmusical.
They look awful.
They look a long way. They probably will go a long way.
They're forming a rival band.
Just don't blame me, you're dragging me across your sea.
Has got no electricity service. They don't get TV and they don't get radio at all, so they actually don't know anything about us whatsoever. If you want to sort of communicate in Newry, you have to talk to the nearest cow. So, you know, you really have to get to either Dublin or Belfast before anybody's got a phone. And there's only 3 phones in Belfast. The rest of them have been blowing up.
I've got 2 of them.
He's got 2 of them. I was wondering why it takes so long to make a phone call. You got them all.
Not for me.
Are we ready
to rock or not? Answer, we are. We're really rockers! It's ready! I want to electrify my senses, stretch my nerves and save my soul. I want to live in my own shelter, free from terror and control. Kiss your heart of darkness till my mind begins to soar. Till the daytime turns to night and I can't stand it anymore. I wanna take all the chances.
Is the new album good?
It's crap.
No. No, it's a stormer. The new album. It's the new album.
It's a corker.
It's corker. It's brilliant. It's a brilliant album, yeah.
It's a long album.
Yeah, it is a long album.
And it's a round album.
Yeah, it is round. Long and round.
When it feels like you can't afford to run, what do you do when the pressure gets too much? Where is that sensual thing? Where is that sensual thing? Is it the place where my life begins? Where is that sensual thing? I want to reach out, grab the...
Why is it circular? Well, because of the global sort of thing, you know, the world, one world, it's continuous, and it, you know, yeah. And rock and roll is a very serious business. You know, because, I mean, you know, we're thinking one world, you know, peace, love, common good, you know. We're also worried about global warming, you know, and...
This is actually December we're sitting here.
It's actually
you
Christmas
see that
Eve.
Hole in the ozone layer up there?
And we're sitting in Oslo.
That's why he's invented this new sort of anti-cancer device in his head.
It
reflects the sun's glow.
Yeah, it absorbs CFC gases. And when I walk into a darkened room, my head glows.
My cabinet's open wide. I'll take something to make me go wild.
A lot of videos that are too literal just completely tear the backside out of a good song.
Mary's got a new job, working in the bank, making lots of money, giving it to Frank. Frank's a married boyfriend, been that way for a year. Slapped her in the face once, but says he loves it. Oh Mary, why don't you have some sense? Please do something to restore my car.
I remember seeing a video for, I think it was, what was that Malcolm McLaren song?
Madame Butterfly?
Madame Butterfly. And the video was just basically a sauna with, you know, women reclining in the sauna and they didn't do anything. And it was a great video because there was loads of images going on in my mind during that video.
But were in the sauna?
I was in the sauna.
Built in a bread shed, covered in a cloth.
first video we did cost us a fiver. Well, the great thing about shooting on your own home video is you can shoot a weekend's worth of material. Able to get loads of interesting mistakes, and we sped up people and we slowed people down, and we basically took the most interesting 3 minutes, no matter what it was, and edited it together in a way that we sort of thought worked with the song. Thing looked a bit weird. In fact, it looked weirder than any video we've done since. It's one of the great rock and roll myths that there's creepies everywhere. There isn't. But hey, we're working on it.
And exactly where are they?
Yeah, where are they right now? No, it's funny, I think you need, unless you adopt the Tom Jones approach.
Which he's working on.
Which I am working on. Which is basically you've got the side of the stage where you sort of lean over and sort of point to the happening looking woman who is then escorted backstage to meet you. So apparently you do it with about 5 or 6, you know, but... The problem is we've got all fellas in the front of our stages, so we don't seem to be able to get them one together. But we're in touch with Tom Jones's management as we speak to try and figure out how he's
how he basically gets the bras thrown up at him instead of the bottles.
Yeah, the bras, yeah, big ones at that.
As Tom would say, it's not unusual.
It's not unusual, no.
There is love reaching out his hand to strengthen me.
I remember when we made it up, I was completely out of it. And the chorus goes, that's the chorus. And I just thought, hey, that's a really cool chorus. You know, that is a really, who the hell would make up a chorus like that? And you need to be out of it to make up a chorus like that. But it actually got onto the record, it still sounded good. Three grunts is a great chorus.
Car crash at 80 miles an hour has like an out of control feel, and that the whole song nearly does sound like a car skidding across a road just about to hit something.
My favourite at the moment is a song called She Hits Me. I've got a friend I can count on. She sits beside me when I am on my own, and slips inside me with her own liquid ease. She comes around to keep me company. It's about a person's, an alcoholic's relationship with drink, and I just really identify with the character. Not that I've got a drink problem or anything, you understand, but I just really identify with the character in the song. She hits me with her eye. She leaves me paralyzed. She hits me with her eye. She hits me.
It sort of assaults you when you listen to it. In the middle, there's this guy who basically wants it all. He wants everything, and he wants it like right now. And he isn't beating about the bush. You know, it's like he's saying things like, I want to reach out, grab the night and touch the stars. I want to waste some of my existence in the streets and in the bars. And it's just like, and he's just starting and he's going, you know, I want it all.
I want to reach out, grab the night and touch the stars. I want to waste some existence in the streets and in the bars. I want to burst outside this canned reality. I want to turn it around and see it like the way it's meant to be.
My favorite's I Miss You, the second song on the album. It's got a really loose feel. I love the rhythm section in it. It's so liquid and flowing, you know. It's just, when we do it live, it's a song I enjoy playing most.
I miss you.
Cooter would say it's as loose as a goose.
He's a drummer, and for some reason, no matter what part of the world we're in, women just molest him to death. So he's got a number of serious disguises. You may be able to spot him over there. He's the guy in the sort of mid-eastern look he's going for at the moment.
The first day we moved in, Paul went up to the door asking, because the neighbour had a key. And he knocked the door and he said, you know, I'm moving in next door, can you give me the key? And there's an old woman next door and she says, oh, are you moving in with your mother and father then? Paul says, no, I'm moving in with a couple of mates. And the whole neighbourhood, the repercussions from that, it just devalued the whole neighbourhood within about 3 months. Then the racket started coming out and we started rehearsing in the...
And the neighbours started, you know, to move.
It was a good area before we moved in.
Money tonight. Drunk tomorrow, drunk tonight, hangover tomorrow, feeling good tonight, feeling shit tomorrow, faith tonight, faithless tomorrow, there's a song for the faithless.
Working in the bank, making lots of money and giving it to Frank. Frank's a married boyfriend, been that way for a year. Slapped her in the face once, but says he loves her all married. Well, why don't you have some sense? Can you please do something to restore my confidence? Let it go, no, no, no.
This album kicks a lot of ass, and so that's when we finished it, we were completely happy with it, and it does, you know. Anybody who doesn't think it does has basically got something on the other side of their head that resembles a cauliflower.